Twitter. I always worry about people thinking that I only commented and friended them because I have a hidden agenda of recruiting them. Am I making this story up in my head? Can you relate? How did you overcome this?
Yeah, you're only thinking that because you know you've got something to address. You're only thinking that because they have no idea. And one thing that helped me was I just focused on building relationships, and then I just picked one and then 2 days a week where I was like, you know what? I'm just going to tear the Band-Aid off and I'm just going to ask the question. And that really helped me because a lot of people are like, well, when do I ask it? Is it too soon? Is it too late? Do I have to build a relationship for 27 years and go to their kids' birthdays and become the godparent before I can ask them? And yeah, you just have to be able to connect. You've got the gift you've got to give. If you all you've got to do is give it. If people don't like it, they can throw it away. They can give it to a friend. But you have to give that. You've got to get comfortable giving it. So yeah, a lot of it's in our head. Don't limit your success based on like other people's thoughts of what you're doing. So yeah, it's you just rip the Band-Aid off.
Okay, I have one more question for each of our trainers for today, for Brian, for Ann, and for Fraser. Same question. How do I make people stay after recruiting? Majority are tourists, or after the subscription, they don't answer anymore. It's so hard for me and my team to make them stay and start doing the actions. So, Brian, how do you get more retention of business builders in your business?
A couple things. Number one, I want to make sure they get a quick win right away. You always talk about that. If they just make $1, you bought some a little bit more of their time. One of the things I also have always taught, because I had to learn this, when somebody signs their distributor agreement, they've done nothing more than signed a written permission slip for you to keep recruiting them. So sometimes we stop recruiting way too soon. We need to keep recruiting them until they're making a full-time living off of their network marketing business. So that's very, very important. Never stop recruiting them. One other thing I did, I'm not here to promote books, but last year, because I find so many distributors, not just prospects, so many distributors just don't understand that the key to time freedom that everybody says they want is financial freedom. But if you're having to trade your time for money, then you'll never have time freedom unless you've got passive residual income coming in. And that's why, you know, and again, I'm not here to pitch it, but that's why I had to write a book, because I couldn't have enough conversations enough. So I wrote Untrapped so that I could actually, you know, send it out to my team members when they join. I'll have my team members, the leaders, do the same exact thing. If they can actually read a book that will sell them on their trapped lifestyle, the need to get untrapped, the need for passive residual income, and how network marketing solves for that, all in one read, that has been really, really good. Matter of fact, we've actually made it again. It came out last year. This December, next month, is our book of the month for our team again, for our associates and for prospects that are on the fence. They just aren't sold on, hey, do I need a part-time side business? You know, Jim Rohn always taught you work hard all day at your job to earn a living, but you should be working spare time, nights, and weekends building your fortune. They think that they're on a path to build their fortune at their job. But awareness. So we just need to raise awareness. And again, what I don't want to see anybody in our profession do is do what got some companies in recent years in trouble with the law. We don't need to go out there and tell college students that college is a waste of time. We don't need to go out there and bash anybody for having a job. College is good. Jobs are good. But we just need to sell people on there is a better way, and network marketing and residual income is the key. And even though, and again, you know, Eric, when at the beginning of the Empire book, I have what you taught me, which is that 5-year, you know, kind of chart. You're going to get paid a little bit of money at the beginning for doing all that work, so that later on you get paid a whole lot of money for work you don't have to do it ever again. And people need to visualize that. They need to internalize it. They need to grasp it and own it, and that's going to keep them around.
I'm going to go to Ann second, but before I do that, I would just say, write down the word launch. Write down the word launch. It's a much better word than getting a person started. Think about duplication and retention is vastly improved if you help a person launch their business, not start their business, launch their business. So I want you to think in terms of that. How can you help a person launch their business, earn their first commission check, get a customer, start building a little bit of a team, get connected to other friends inside of the business, tell the world what they're going to do, all the things that we talk about in getting a person going. But launch is the key. Okay, so I just want you, that tiny little word distinction is a big one. Everybody in your organization should be thinking about, how can I launch the new people that are joining my team on a daily basis versus how to get them started. It's a completely different energy. Think about that. It will help you. Ann, go ahead.
I love that, Eric. And I would say, okay, so we say onboard, but I love launch.
Yeah, launch is better than onboard, right?
Yeah,
onboard sounds like a boring thing you do the day before college. you know what I mean? It's like a tutorial that you got to take, you know, when you're going to get that factory job. Launching is total different energy and a better energy. So, how do you get more retention and duplication?
Okay, so launch them right away. Don't let that be a option. Like, launch them, you anchor them, and then you build them. So you launch them, which means give them just enough tools to get started. You get them paid. You anchor them when you get them paid. Somebody's going to stick around if they're getting paid, right? So show them how to make money right away. Get on the phone with their first couple recruits. Help them. You don't just send them into oblivion and say, good luck, right? It is your responsibility as a sponsor to launch them properly. You wouldn't start a job at Walmart and then turn you loose at the cash register and say, man, I hope you do it well. Like, I hope it works out for you. You would teach them how to do that. So you have to help them. Your first 30 to 60 days, you are all hands on deck. Now, I will say this. You can't make somebody want it enough. So you will have people that come on board and just will not do much for their business. And that's fine. They're going to provide a little volume. They're going to be a little meat and potatoes for your volume. That's why you're always building and rebuilding, as Eric tells us. You're always looking for the next person. But your job is to launch them, to get them paid. You anchor them by getting them paid, and then you start building. Then they step into leadership and they learn more.
Fraser, how do you answer that?
Yeah, so I believe, first and foremost, we need to get them emotionally connected. So what I would do is I would have a conversation. Hey, you're welcome. This is your launch call to get things started. So I want you to imagine you're in the movie Aladdin, and you stumble across the genie lamp. You give it a rub, and I was to come out, and I was to give you one wish. What would your wish be? And it can't be for more wishes. And they say, oh, I want to travel the world. Why? So I can experience things. Why? Why? I would try to get so deep so that I know when the time comes, because hey guys, everyone goes through a dip, right? Leaders are created in the dip. I need to be able to tell it back to them. Hey, is traveling the world with your kids and experience great things, is that still important to you? If so, I'm here. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. The second thing is I'm going to give a simple action assignment. So it's going to be something that anyone can do. And here's the key. I don't want to be like, you got to do this, you got to do this. I'm going to tell them this. So I'm going to say, your first assignment is to write your list. The average person completes this assignment in 24 hours. Are you above average or below average? No one says below average. So don't tell me, show me. So I'm now going to have another call, follow-up call. There'll be three types of people. First type, they give you an excuse. The dog ate my new phone, right? The second one is they make it on time and they say they did it. Okay, well done. The third type are the people who call you after an hour of you giving the assignment and say, right, I've done it, what's next? Jim Rohn talks about identification, and I believe identification is the key to duplication. We need to identify who are going to do it before they've actually done it, right? So Eric talks about assignments all the time. The third one, I think, is understanding that a lack of motivation isn't the issue. It's a lack of clarity. Really knowing, like, what exactly do we need to do? And this is one of the reasons why I believe GoPro. I go to GoPro every single year is because I get clarity on what I need to do for the next year. This industry is so young and it's changing so fast. And every single event, I get clarity on what's working for different leaders around the world. Yeah, the motivation's great, but the clarity is just worth millions upon millions upon millions. So emotionally connect with their wish, give them a simple action assignment, and then look for, give them clarity, not motivation.
So I want to give you a couple assignments. Number one is the Snow Angel Challenge. Number two, and post that inside of the group. Number two, if you don't have your Virtual GoPro ticket, I want you to go to virtualgopro.com right now, this minute. Click on that link and register for that and get the $2,100 worth of free bonuses. If you already have a ticket, I have a different assignment for you. I want you to identify one person on your team that doesn't have a ticket yet. And I want you to make sure that before you go to sleep tonight, that person is registered for GoPro. One person on your team, make sure that that person is registered for GoPro before you go to sleep. If you accept that challenge, put "I accept" into the comments. Okay, Snow Angel, and either a ticket or you're going to bring a friend. Let me see the accepts. Don't be a tourist and just lay there. Let me see it. Come on. Every single one of you, let me know. Before you go to sleep tonight, you're going to get a ticket, or you're going to have one person on your team that has a ticket, and sometime soon, whatever, whenever is appropriate, you're going to do the Snow Angel Challenge, okay? And you